how we're doing. So here we are at the top of Blackpool Tower, having an awesome time. This morning we went to a circus, and between the circus and our tower viewing slot, we had a bit of time. So we ventured to a gaming shop here in Blackpool, got some nice pickups. I was hoping to go back to the car first before we got back to the tower, but unfortunately we ran out of time. I had the bigger games with me, and trust me, Blackpool Tower lift and Nintendo cardboard, it's not a great mix, but hopefully they make it home unscathed. I was going to do a pickup video, but it's a bit busy, so I think I'm going to leave it until I get home back to a Boston Arcade Yeah. Anyways, cheers guys! Hi guys, how are we doing? Well, we're now back from the dizzy heights of Blackpool Tower to the Lost and Arcade and Arcade. And today I'm going to get straight into the pickups. First up, purchases from CX. I got two games. Firstly, Batman for Mega Drive. All complete and in really nice condition. Next up, we've got an N64 game. Jet Force Gemini, known as Star Twins, over in Japan.
おいでおいでおいで、はい、ルプスルプスルプス。この犬はルプスと言いましてね、非常に珍しい種類なんです。ほら、よーく見てください。背中に武器がしょってますね。無傷通性があるんですね。ブンブンブンブン。よーし、よしよし、ここでも売ってますね。
Yeah, it's all complete and in nice condition. When I purchased it, I thought it might have been slightly faded. I gave it a wipe over with a slightly damp baby wipe, and it must have been owned by a smoker because it was covered in a thin layer of tar. It was pretty disgusting, really. But yeah, it's cleaned up nicely, and I'm really happy to add it to the collection. I've got the faintest memories of owning this back in the day, but I don't think I put much time in it. I can't remember much about it, so yeah, really looking forward to giving this one another go. After CEX, we headed to Eclipse Home Entertainment, an awesome video game shop, about 10-15 minutes walk from the town centre. It's an awesome little shop. It's got a great selection of games, from modern to retro. And when you go inside, it reminds me a lot of old video rental shops they had back in the day with the wooden paneling. Yeah, quite a retro interior. But yeah, I've got some nice games. I'll start with PlayStation, modernish to retro. Gran Turismo 6 on the PS3. I'm always a sucker for a steelbook.
Wolfenstein? The New Order? And Deus Ex, Human Revolution. So yeah, looking forward to playing these. And I also got some PS1 titles. I'd say that was one of the strengths of the shop. They had an awesome PS1 selection, great selection of games, and a really nice condition. First up, we've got Medieval 2.
Saddam is back. The undead can run, but they can't hide. Rated T for teens.
A game I've heard great things about. Well, the first one and the second one, and I haven't tried it myself, so yeah, looking forward to playing that. Overblood 2. Now this looks interesting, like a sci-fi adventure game, and the graphical style looks sort of a bit like Resident Evil, and yeah, certainly looks interesting, and one I haven't come across before. Next up, an old favourite of mine, the awesome Tekken 3.
どこまで進化するのか?
Tekken 3
PlayStation. Then another Namco classic and one of my favorite puzzle games, Mr. Driller.
Mr. Driller.
I have got a dedicated Klax arcade machine, and I am a bit tempted to put a Mr. Driller PCB in the Klax. Yeah, really, really happy to pick it up on the PlayStation. And another PS1 title, Necronomicon, The Dawning of Darkness. Looks like a horror point-and-click adventure. And then we move on to some Nintendo. Another nice feature of a shop, they had like a cabinet of sealed games across various formats, and that's just sort of, it's not something you see very often. So many sealed games. And I got this one. Now I have to admit I mainly got this game for the Transformer, and I was a little bit disappointed to find out that it's not really an actual Transformer, just the doors of a car open, which is a bit of a shame, but still a nice purchase. And finally, my last pickup and my favourite pickup of the day. The awesome Life Force, also known as Salamander, for an S.
Super Visual Famicom Salamander, 8月21日 発売 が 9月25日 に 変わりました.
Konami. All complete and a nice condition. Awesome shooter, and I absolutely love the cover art on this one. Yeah, it's probably one of my favourite video game cover arts ever. And that's quite fitting, really. Quite a fitting purchase, because the following day, we went to Arcade Club in Blackpool. And when you go into the entrance, they've got this like massive mural of this Salamander art. And I'll put a video in the corner to show you the art. And it looks absolutely stunning. So yeah, quite fitting that I also picked this one up in Blackpool. So they're my pickups for the day. I'd definitely recommend going to Eclipse if you get a chance. Cheers, guys. See you on the next one.